والحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. قال الله تعالى: وإن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها. وقال تعالى: قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. وقال تعالى: نبئ عبادي أني أنا الغفور الرحيم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى الآل وصحب الكرام. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالاً كثيراً ونساءاً واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيباً. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولاً سديداً يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزاً عظيماً. ألا فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكما ورد في الرواية وكل ضلالة في النار. ألا فاتقوا الله عباد الله وتمسكوا من الإسلام بالعروة الوثقى واحذروا غضب الرب فإن أجسادكم على النار لا تكوى. O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, all praises belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we seek His assistance and guidance. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evil of ourselves and the adverse consequences of our deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can misguide. And whomsoever Allah misguides, none can guide. And peace and salutations be upon the final messenger, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship besides one Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger. O servants of Allah, and O children of Adam, as we began this khutbah, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the many gifts He has given us, we recognize the gift of this day of Jumu'ah. This day about which Islam has taught us is the day of Eid in the week of a believer. And in Sahih Muslim, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he reports that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَفْضَلُ يَوْمٍ طَلَعَتْ عَلَيْهِ الشَّمْسِ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ فِيهِ خُلِقَ آدَمْ وَفِيهِ أُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ وَفِيهِ أُخْرِجَ مِنْهَا وَلَا تَقُومُ السَّاعَةِ إِلَّا فِي يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ. That the best day upon which the sun rises is this day of Jumu'ah. On this day Allah created Adam alayhi salam, and on this day Allah entered him into Jannah, and on this day Allah removed him from Jannah, and the coming of the hour will not happen except on this day of Jumu'ah. May Allah make us from the people of Jannah when the coming of the hour arrives. Ameen. From the gifts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us, and this is the corpus of instruction in my message to you today, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the most merciful. He is the most forgiving. He is the most merciful. And this gift is a gift that never allows anyone who declares Allah as one, and anyone who has accepted Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as the final messenger, to ever lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has many names and many attributes. And He has many names and attributes that fall under the topic of compassion and mercy. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ar-Rahman, and He is Ar-Rahim, and He is Al-Ghafir, and He is Al-Ghaffar, and He is Al-Ghafoor, and He is Al-Mannan, and He is Al-Barr, and He is Al-Afu. And these are just some names from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma laka alhamd, hamdan kathiran, tayyiban mubarakan fih, kama yuhibbu rabbuna wa yarda. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most deserving of all, the most beautiful of praises. For indeed, Allah has showered upon us gifts that we can never count and we can never audit. Ar-Rahman, this name from the names of Allah, upon the Arabic scale of Fa'lan. And this name is a description of Allah's mercy and teaches us how vast the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. And this name teaches us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy is so vast that nothing from the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can escape His mercy. Not even the disbelievers. They cannot escape the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah tells us in His book, He commands Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to recite to the Quraysh His ayah, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ مَا يَأْبَأُ بِكُمْ رَبِّي. Tell them, O Muhammad, that their du'as, their supplications are answered despite their enmity towards Allah, despite their enmity towards you, despite the oppression that they act upon and in by associating partners with Allah. Tell them that Allah, tell them that they remain in existence and they enjoy a financial standing and they enjoy a material well-being. Why? Because of their dua to Allah. That they raise their hands and they pray, and Ar-Rahman preserves them because of that dua. Ar-Rahman, the entirely merciful. The one whose mercy is so vast that no one can escape His mercy, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about Him being Ar-Rahman and about His mercy, وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. That My mercy encompasses everything. Nothing can escape the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as Allah is Ar-Rahman, He is Ar-Rahim subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ar-Rahman, we described it as the one who is entirely merciful. And Ar-Rahim, we describe as the one who is especially merciful. The one who has a specific, special mercy for the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For those who died upon the way of the messengers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent them. That if you die having listened to the message of the messenger, then you will enjoy rahmah from Ar-Rahman, and you will enjoy rahmah and mercy from Ar-Rahim. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes Allah as Rahman al-dunya wal-akhirah wa rahimahuma. The Rahman of this life and the next, and the Rahim of this life and the next. So Allah is Ar-Rahman, the entirely merciful, and Ar-Rahim, the especially merciful. And when we understand this, we come across other names of Allah, such as the name Ghafir, the one who forgives. That if a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala slips and falls into sin, then they never allow shaitan to make them sad. They know that I have a Rabb who is Al-Ghafir, the one who forgives. So he turns and she turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and forgiveness is sought, and Al-Ghafir forgives them. But what about the person who seeks forgiveness from Allah and then sins after that again? They slip after that again. Sometimes we have sins that overpower us. We hate them. We hate those sins. We hate displeasing Allah. But they overpower us. We're in a period of fighting that sin, and we slip to block the door to shaitan coming to you and making you lose hope in Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim by whispering to you that, don't you feel shame? You won't be forgiven. You made a sin and you asked for forgiveness and you're sinning again. To help us, Allah teaches us that from His names is not just Al-Ghafir, but Al-Ghaffar. Al-Ghaffar refers to the one who perpetually forgives. The one who forgives you after forgiving you. And He forgives you after forgiving you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what about the case of a person who's lived decades of their life sinning, sinning and sinning, and towards the end, they realize the error of their ways. They hate the decades that they lived through, and they feel hurt for the actions of their life. And now shaitan comes to them and whispers to them that there's no way you're going to go to Jannah. There's no way you're going to be forgiven. You've spent the majority of your life displeasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have no chance. For this person, Allah teaches us that Allah is Al-Ghafoor. And Al-Ghafoor is upon the Arabic scale of Fa'ul. And names that are based upon this scale denote a meaning of occupation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us that it is Allah's occupation to forgive you, irrespective of your circumstance. If the realization has come, you have no choice. You have no other door to walk through besides the door of Al-Ghafoor. So don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah and walk through that door, O servant of Allah and O child of Adam. These are some names from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we understand this, O servant of Allah, it is not strange when we read in a hadith Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, يَبْنَ آدَمْ إِنَّكُمْ تُخْضِئُونَ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ وَأَنَا أَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا فَاسْتَغْفِرُونِ أَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ. It is not strange when we read that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, يَبْنَ آدَمْ لَوْ بَلَغَ الذُّنُوبُكَ أَنَانِ السَّمَاءِ ثُمَّ اسْتَغْفَرْتَ لِي لَغَفَرْتُهَا لَكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي. It's not strange when we read in a hadith Qudsi that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O son of Adam, if you sinned and sinned and sinned, that your sins fill the environments that you live in. They've reached the surfaces of the skies. That's how many sins you have done. And then you sincerely turn to Allah, sincerely, and seek forgiveness from Allah. Allah says, لَغَفَرْتُهَا لَكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي. I will forgive your sins for you, and it won't even matter to Allah. This is nothing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not strange that Allah says, يَبْنَ آدَمْ O son of Adam, you sin during the day and you sin during the night. But it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who forgives all sins. Allah says, فَاسْتَغْفِرُونِي. So seek forgiveness from me. And what does Allah say? Does He say, I will forgive you? He says, أَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ. It's in the form of جَوَابُ شَرْطٍ. On condition of you seeking forgiveness, consider yourself forgiven. Not I will forgive you. Consider yourself forgiven. Meaning, don't get up from the place that you sought forgiveness from, doubting whether Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven you. Have good hope in Allah, believing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven you. That if you were to pass away at that time, then you are forgiven from the mistakes that you have done. This is known as husnul dhan, and having good hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded us never to die except whilst having good hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Understand who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, O servant of Allah and O child of Adam. I introduce you to your Lord, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Ghafir, Al-Ghaffar, Al-Ghafur, Al-Mannan, Al-Bar, Al-Tawwab, Al-Afu, subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from ever losing hope in Him. Ameen. And may Allah forgive our past and inspire our futures. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil wahyain wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bihadi sayyidi al-thaqalain. Laqad qultu ma qult wa astaghfirullah al-azim al-jaleel li wa lakum wa li sa'iril al-muslimina min kulli dhanbi wa khati'ah. Fastaghfiruh innahu kana ghaffara wa tubu ilayh innahu kana tawwab. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله وخيرته من خلقه صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجه واكتفى أثره ودعا بدعوته إلى يوم الدين فإنه تركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك أما بعد فاتقوا الله عباد الله واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he teaches us about a sincere slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This slave commits a sin, but he doesn't lose hope in the mercy of Allah. He turns to Allah and he says, Ya Rabbi, O my Lord, أَذْنَبْتُ ذَنْبًا فَاغْفِرْ لِي. I have committed a sin, forgive me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructs his angels to bear witness that he's forgiven. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, and then the slave sins again, and he doesn't lose hope in the mercy of Allah. He turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again. He knows that Allah is Al-Ghafir, but He's also Al-Ghaffar. And he sincerely asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informs the angels that he's forgiven. And then he sins again. And he turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because he knows that Allah is al-ghafir and he is al-ghaffar and he is al-ghafoor subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he doesn't lose hope in the mercy of Allah and he seeks forgiveness again from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informs his angels to bear witness that this slave of Allah is one who knows that he has a Rabb, a Lord who is all capable over him, and that the same Rabb is the most forgiving, the most merciful. Bear witness that whatever he does from today, he's forgiven. La ilaha illallah. This is easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O servants of Allah, O children of Adam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is perfect from ever, and he's perfect forever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was Ar-Rahman before he showed mercy, was Al-Ghafir before he forgave, Al-Khaliq before he created. He never needed to forgive someone to be known as Al-Ghafir. He was already Al-Ghafir before anyone needed forgiveness. He never needed someone to beseech his mercy to be called Ar-Rahman. He was already Ar-Rahman subhanahu wa ta'ala before he had to show mercy to anyone subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is perfect from ever and he is perfect forever. This is easy for Allah. In the books of Sunan, in the other compilations of hadith, there's a hadith known as hadithul bitaqa, the hadith of the card. And I try and imagine this card as a business card, a small card. And it states that a servant will be brought to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the angels to produce the files of the slave. And 99 files of sin will be produced. Each file as big as the eye can see of sin. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn to his slave and ask his slave. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to his slave, did my angels oppress you? Do these books have records that are not from your actions and not from your statements and not from your behaviors? There's no hiding from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah. The angel will say, no, I haven't been oppressed. Allah will command the angels to put the books on the scales of deeds. Then Allah will ask for his good deeds to be brought. And one file that does not resemble the 99 files is produced. And human nature affects the slave of Allah. And he understands what his plight is going to be like. And Allah tells the angels to place the book on the scales of deeds. And as the angels do so, a card falls out, a bitaqa. So this hadith is known as hadithul bitaqa. And nothing happens to the scales. Obviously, one file, thin file, in front of 99 thick files, each file as long as the eye can see, nothing's going to happen to the scales. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the angels to place the card that fell out onto the scales. And when this card falls onto the scales tip in the favor of the slave. And his result is Jannah. I know what you're thinking right now, because I had the same thought when I came across this narration. What was on the card? On the card was Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasul. That there is no one worthy of worship besides one Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger. Wallahi wa billahi wa tallahi. A Muslim can never ever lose hope in the mercy of Allah. And as we go through the names of Allah, we come across a name, Al-Afu. And Al-Afu is known as a qualitative name of Allah, because it gives extra meaning to the other names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Al-Afu refers to the one who effaces your sin, obliterates your sin, causes your sin to destruct, to become self-destructed, that there's no trace of the sin left. This is how perfect Allah is in forgiving us. And to better understand it, think of sometimes what we do when we sin on our computers. May Allah protect us. You sin and you delete it. Where does it go? To the recycle bin. You think it's gone. No, it's there. If somebody says, no, I'm a bit clever, I don't use recycle bin, I use shift delete. Somebody taught me this. When I do shift delete, it doesn't go to the recycle bin. I delete it. When I go to the recycle bin, it's not there. I have some bad news for you. Your sin can still be found. But if somebody says, I have learned a bit more IT, done a bit more hardware. I use something called formatting. I format the hard disk. You say, okay, a bit extreme. But I have some bad news for you. Your sin can still be found. Why? Because even though the computer tells you that there's now no information on your computer, it tells you that the hard disk has all the space for you to save new information on, it's not really the case. Because the hard disk really is a magnetic platter of layers divided into sectors. And when the computer tells you that something is deleted, it told you it's deleted, but it's still there. The computer just told itself, you are now safe to save new information to the sector. It's all about information on top of information. If somebody has the right computer skills, they can bring back your sins. Somebody says, I'm a professional IT expert. I do a low-level format where I grind the hard disk down to the day I bought it when it came from the manufacturer. We say if you can do that, then you are safe, but not entirely safe. Because the nature of the hard disk is that it has a read-write head on top of it, which doesn't cover the entire circumference of the hard disk. There will be some information on the edges, which if some bored data analyst wants to find out something about you, he will analyze that chatter, that information, and he will tell us something about you. You're never safe. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives you, the ground upon which you made the mistake is made to forget. The angels that recorded the mistakes, they're made to forget. The ink that has logged the mistake disappears. When you meet Allah on the day of Qiyamah, it's as if you never did the mistake in the first place. My dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, may Allah grant us the understanding of who Allah is and protect us from the whispers of shaitan. But before I leave, I had to, as the first khutbah, mashallah, in this wonderful institution, speak about hope, but not false hope. Because after you leave today, shaitan will come to you and tell you, you see that Shaykh Sajid Umar, he came to tell you how merciful Allah is. So don't worry, do the sin and seek forgiveness from Allah. Yes, even if you do the sin, please seek forgiveness from Allah. But shaitan will never guarantee you life after the sin to seek forgiveness from Allah. You don't know if you will breathe after that sin to seek forgiveness from Allah. So don't go home with false hope. Go home with the right hope. Don't plan the sin. But if you slip, don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah. May Allah grant us the understanding. عباد الله إن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى فيه بملائكته الكرام فقال تعالى قولا كريما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما وقد قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى علي صلاة واحدة صلى الله عليه بها عشرة اللهم فصل وسلم وبارك وأنعم على عبدك ورسولك محمد أفضل الخلق وأكرم الرسل وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين الأئمة المهديين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة والتابعين وعنا معهم بمنك وكرمك وإحسانك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم احفظنا بحفظك الذي تحفظ به عبادك الصالحين اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا كلها دقها وجلها سرها وعلنها عمدها وخطأها كل ذلك عندنا يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله إن الله يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقيموا الصلاة يرحمكم الله